Hello students, welcome to the second part of Howard Gardner theory of multiple intelligences. We have already discussed five intelligences. Today we'll cover next three intelligences. Okay, let's study. Next is interpersonal intelligence. Interpersonal intelligence, it is your understanding of others. You have a vast understanding of others. You know their moods, you know their how they will behave. You can take the example of leaders in this. You can take the example of leaders, you can take the example of manager, you can take the example of supervisor, you can take the example of counselor, you can take the example of this public relations, politicians. What qualities they have? They are they have vast understanding of others, how they will behave. So if you take the example of any leader, a leader of an organization or any others, if school, college or university, what qualities they possess? They are high on problem solving skills, they have communication skills, they have social skills, they are high on extroversion, they know, they understand others, they love to be a part of a group, they work well in collaboration, they work in pairs, they love to work in pairs, their communication skill is excellent, so they can create harmony in groups. That's why we want leaders who are having these kind of qualities. What qualities they have? They have interpersonal intelligence, knowledge of others, how others will behave in a particular situation. So this is your understanding of others. They learn through interaction. Interaction is very important for them. They are high on extroversion. They create positive relationship with others. That's why they become leaders. They have empathy. They can understand others' point of view. They are good at resolving conflicts. They assess moods, they can assess the other's temperament, other's emotions, the other's motivation. What motivate others? They know what kind of emotions they have, when they will be happy, when they will be sad. They understand the desires, the intentions of others. They love meeting new people, that's why they are high on in this extroversion. And they love to interview people with knowledge on certain subjects. So you can take the example of these people in order to understand interpersonal intelligence. Next is intrapersonal intelligence. Please read it carefully. Intrapersonal. You know, intrapersonal is adapted looking inward and understanding self. You know about yourself. You know what is your strength. You know what is your weakness. You know what motivates you. You know why you understand why you are doing this. When you have understanding of yourself, it means you are high on intrapersonal intelligence. Knowing yourself, introspection. You love to introspect. You know why you are doing, and what will be the consequences if you do this. Then you are high on intrapersonal intelligence. You love to write diaries. You love to keep a journal. You love to keep a log. You love to write your biography. These kind of people. These kind of people are very intuitive. These people are very rational. These people have got wisdom. They work well in privacy. They don't want to work in groups. They work well when they are alone. Okay. So these kind of people are having intrapersonal intelligence. So you can take the example of philosophers, historians, inventors, scientists, psychologists and counselors. They have wisdom, they have strong will, they have confidence, and they have a strong opinion. They are good at analyzing their own strengths, weakness and abilities. So this is what we mean by intrapersonal intelligence. Last is naturalistic intelligence. Seven we have studied, this is eighth, and this was proposed by Gardner in 1990s. Not in 1983. Okay, this was naturalistic intelligence. Naturalistic intelligence, you are nurturing and relating information to one's natural surroundings. You have knowledge about your environment. You have concerns about your environment. You learn through natural contact. Anything that is in our environment, that is in our surroundings, it fascinates you. If it fascinates you, then you are high on naturalistic intelligence. You must have come across people who show concerns about about these environmental aspects, environmental problems. You have must have come across these kind of people who say that there's air pollution, our environment is now dangerous. We have concerns for them. These people are high on this naturalistic intelligence. They show concerns about endangered species. These species are getting extinct. They have concerns. They are high on this naturalistic intelligence, and they love gardening. They are inspired and rejuvenated by nature. They love to be in contact with nature. These people are high on this. They appreciate scenic views. They love to see the beauty of nature. They appreciate them. They know how to appreciate it. They are aware of weather changes. They love to walk. They love to climb and camp and hike. Anything that is related to environment, anything that is related to nature, it fascinates them. They love it. They love to be in the company of nature. Okay. And you can take the example of animal trainers, geologists, farmers, landscapers, horticulturists, marine biologists. These people are high on naturalistic intelligence. So this was our theory of multiple intelligence given by Gardner. And I must say that you should spend time with these kind of people if you want to understand these this theory. You would be able to understand it better and go through your mind and try to assess which type of intelligence you have. Then this theory will become very interesting for you to understand. Okay, thank you.